Welcome to RMD, All Things Aesthetics and Wellness Podcast with me, your host, Dr. Deborah Durst, and my co-host.
Hey guys, Farida Golombieski, nurse practitioner here at RevitalyzeMD.
So we have a good podcast today because we get this question every day in the office. PRP versus PRF? What is that? And now we have a new PRF gel. So we were going to go into the differences with all of those and how we can use them and how we do use them in the office.
So how they're the same, how they're different, really just how they're different is how we spin them down and pull the material from the blood.
I will say that we stay very on top of any, you know, changes and advances in aesthetics. And so this is one of those. Again, PRP is first generation. PRF is second generation.
And PRF gel is third. So as the science continues to change and evolve, we'll also continue to evolve with that and continue to offer the newest, latest, and greatest services as they come about. Yes. And it's really interesting to see that evolution because we still use PRP for some instances or platelet-rich plasma, where others, PRF or platelet-rich fibrin, is just a better option, just like PRF gel.
It's awesome. Like all of the effects, we just have basically different ways of processing in different applications of each one of them. So we'll start with PRP. Like, what is PRP? And we have other podcasts. So again, at this point, I would want you to like subscribe. You get notifications of any of our podcasts that go up. And we have previous podcasts that talk about this, but it goes way back since we've done PRF versus PRP. And we're the only ones in the area that are actually doing PRF in and around Knoxville. But we love it and we use it on a daily basis. So what is PRP? So PRP is platelet-rich plasma. Your blood have platelets in them, but again, it's spread out in the blood. So what we do is draw your blood, spin it down, and get the platelet concentrate. Mm-hmm. And those platelets have growth factors in them. So if you cut your arm, again, platelets go, stop the bleeding, and all the growth factors in the platelets are released to heal arm tissue or tissue that's injured. So basically we want to use that in areas to tell the tissue it's injured and to get repair or regeneration in some way. It's a lot.
Yeah. But, and then for PRF or platelet-rich fibrin, we're still drawing your blood in that same way. We're still spinning it down and using those platelets, but we're leaving some of that fibrin. We're leaving some of the red blood cells. So we're spinning the blood a little bit slower to leave a little more of those red blood cells so that we can have a higher concentration of what we're utilizing. So sometimes we want those red blood cells. Sometimes we don't. That's why you need to go to somebody experienced so they know when it is appropriate to use these different modalities of treatment.
And again, even with that, so in a very simplistic form, we are processing differently to get different things from your blood to use in different ways. Because sometimes it's beneficial to have red blood cells or white blood cells, and sometimes it's not. And just to kind of go into PRF gel, and then again, we'll go through the applications of PRF gel at the very end, because that's the most advanced third generation PRP or blood-based, you know, aesthetic product or service. So, but what is PRF gel? Well, we're processing it even differently, but we're still drawing blood, spinning it down, but we're processing it in a couple different ways now so that we can now utilize albumin to kind of add a fill factor to the PRP. So there's different applications for that, and we'll talk about that at the very end.
Or even a thicker, more concentrated product.
Oh, yeah. No, and it's a beautiful product. So, and
what I love about all these is the safety profile. We are using your own blood. So the safety profile is fantastic.
Yeah.
It's you.
You really don't have an adverse effect. Like, you can't find adverse effects to PRP products because it is your own blood. And that's how your body is repairing as well. Absolutely. If something happens without us injecting it to repair. The other thing that I would say, again, is kits matter. So what office you go to matters because we're going to use different kits. And I've used, you know.
We've gone through a lot of different kits.
Oh, gosh.
Let's just be blunt. Yeah. We've tried a lot of different kits.
And there are reasons why we use the kits we use now because they're the best and the most concentrated. And again, it allows, we want the couple different things we want to look for in kits we have in the kits we use now. And again, there's different kits for those applications, but flexibility, you know, so that we can get white blood cells or red blood cells when we need it, or just platelets when we need it.
So nobody wants to come in and see us, have us draw their blood, spin it down and go, oh, we didn't yield enough for your treatment, we need to draw more blood and respin. No, you should not have to redraw blood. You should be able to yield enough PRF or PRP from that blood draw for treatment. And that's where kits matter.
Kits
because
matter.
We've used kits that do not yield enough. And we're like, how did 60 cc's of blood turn out to this much product?
Yeah.
Why is this occurring?
And I think one of the key factors, again, that we try to tell our patients and again, just reminding and consents is to hydrate prior to any of these procedures.
Always.
And using non-steroidals can actually affect the function of the platelets too. So those two things are important to note. Prior to any blood-based athletic procedures or PRP, PRF, PRF gel.
Absolutely.
And so flexibility, again, you know, that reliability, consistency, making sure that all the nurses and all the staff are using the kits the same way. They're easy enough to use and fast enough that you don't have to spend an hour waiting just for us to process that and then maybe getting inconsistent results based on different staff. So this is, our kits are very, we lay out, you know, procedures to do. It's consistent between all staff and it's very easy and highly effective at getting the results and the product that we want. So those are all important FDA approved, you know,
kits,
to make
yeah.
sure that they're all FDA approved. And, you know, so again, those are some of the things we look for and we feel like we have the best kit. So we can never absolutely predict your response to, you know, one of our services, but when we're using our services, we know the best techniques on how to apply and utilize the product that we're doing or the service that we're providing, and also that we're using the best products.
Absolutely. So that way we have we're in the very best position to give you the best
results.
Treatment that we can every single time consistently.
Yeah.
And that was something really when we went to an aesthetic conference two, three years ago now,
yeah.
where we were talking to one of the other physicians that's been doing it forever. And even he brought that up. It is so important to have that consistency, to have the right kits, to be processing it the same every single time for that consistency.
Yeah. And then the concentration, that's actually probably the most important, but we hadn't talked about that, to make sure that you're getting the most concentrated platelet. So
Absolutely.
How many times the concentration of normal blood. And so for instance, one of the most, like, and I won't mention the kit specifically, but that product and manufacturer, again, it was like 1.8 times your normal blood on a good day. And so one would be your baseline, which is just pulling your blood and using it versus
yes.
spinning it down to get the platelets. But again, it was only a 22 ml draw. And, you know, you need like way more than that because, again, the amount of platelets you're going to get and then concentrate are dependent on how much blood you draw too. So
absolutely.
And then how you concentrate it, the flexibility, and again, even pH and all kinds of other things. So
using kits matter.
Kits matter for sure. So, and then basically some of the uses of, like, we're going to talk about PRP, and that's what we kind of talked about first is, so what are some of the uses of PRP?
So PRP can be used on the face, right? So you can use it, you can inject it, you can microneedle with it. You can use it for sexual wellness treatments like the O shot and the P shot. We use PRP with almost every single aesthetic treatment where we are microneedling, using a laser, putting any kind of channel into the skin, whether it's energy, needling, anything topical that we can do for regeneration healing for fine lines and wrinkles. Always recommend adding PRP to those treatments.
So you're going to have less downtime and you're going to have better healing and better results if you have PRP add-on. So again, like Faraday said, anytime you're microneedling or creating injury to the skin entry point, so laser or needles, you know, whether it's energy with needles or not, if you can put PRP, it seeps down in there and you get better, again, results with those procedures. And orthopedics is another reason I think they still
joints.
Use. Yes.
We don't do a ton of that here.
No, not a ton. I mean, we can do it on patients that are already here, you know, doing something, but the orthopedic doctors do that. And that's actually historically kind of where PRP started, is joints and orthopedics. So, and a great safety profile. So therefore, when we get to PRF, We have that same safety profile, but now we're processing it differently. So again, we're not spinning it as long or
as fast.
So that now when we're spinning it long and fast, we're getting everything out of it but platelets. And sometimes we want some white blood cells, some growth factors, some red blood cells, like Faraday said.
Yes.
And so we want to spin it differently. And with that, so PRP, because we want the injection times to be a little bit longer, we need to put an anticoagulant in it so that it doesn't clot prior to us injecting. So after the draw, after the preparation, but prior to us injecting, sometimes with PRP, we might activate it. So we put something in the product, but we definitely have anticoagulant in it.
Yes.
PRF, we have nothing. Like, it's just your blood with no additional products because, number one, maybe we don't need as much downtime for the injection we're doing. But also, we are not going to have a clot not form. And after we inject, the clot does form.
Absolutely.
And so now the platelets are trapped in that clot and are released over a longer and slower period of time, like 7 to 10 days.
So we're getting a more concentrated product. So more is not always better, as we know. That's why we still keep PRP around. But when it comes to things like hair regeneration, and we're looking at hair restoration or under the eyes, under the eye bags,
dark circles, looking tired, all that.
PRF just really shines, and we see just
so
amazing results.
Yeah.
Absolutely. So when we're looking at PRP, you're looking at a concentration 4 times that of your blood. With PRF, you're looking at 10 times that concentration. So it's a big difference between the two. A lot of people would say, oh, well, then why not just use PRF? Well, again, there's no anticoagulant. We want it to clot. We do not want clotting in some areas of the body.
Yeah. You don't want clotting with all areas. So like in sexual wellness, I'm not sure that I would want to inject PRF and it form a clot in a penis after I inject it. So there's certain reasons why you would not want, and that's one obvious. And again, even those concentrations will also depend on what kit you're using. But yes, and so sometimes we want those release of growth factors over a longer period of time, like 7 to 10 days, in the scalp and hair is a perfect example of that.
Exactly.
And again, the results are amazing for eyes and hair. And those are just two. And again, we touch on PRF in separate videos, but you can use it for the face and just aesthetics and fill. And it regenerates everything. You have better color and blood flow and healing process or, ability in the face when we inject it, versus even microneedling and topical application. Then we get finally to third generation PRF gel, which is a fabulous product. Again, I was a little hesitant to bring it on because things evolve in over this last year. That was an evolution that happened pretty quickly.
I think with COVID, a lot of people were home.
Yeah.
Researchers, docs, experimenters, we had a lot of time to kind of explore and see, well, what can we do?
Yeah.
How do we utilize these things? What's safe? What's not safe? How does this look? How does this not
look? And this was a quick progression. So really, if an office is only using PRP, then you want to look for PRF and PRF gel too. And again, there's different applications for each one. But PRF gel, again, it's all your own blood, and now we're processing it in different ways. So PRP is processed one way. PRF, a different, like we talked about, and then PRF gel, now we're processing it in a more advanced way where we're separating it out almost into PRF and then an albumin processing. And
yes.
So now we're taking that albumin and kind of getting, and then we combine them and get a fill. It's almost as good as filler, and the product's amazing. It's so smooth. It's easy to inject.
Absolutely.
But you get a ton of product. So with this, we're really doing a face with it because it's too much to use under the eye because it's a filler. Like it acts like a filler. It injects like a filler.
And it,
it's amazing.
It acts like a filler. So when we put it into the cheek.
Oh, it's amazing.
It is amazing. And it's your own blood product.
Yeah.
I mean, that's what blows my mind is that this is really big advances when we're looking at injectables.
Yes.
For aesthetic purposes.
Yeah. Well, and especially for those that are maybe afraid of filler, this, again, is your own blood and it's used for a fill and a stimulation of collagen elastin. And so, but you can use it, in the jaw, the chin, the cheeks, the eyes, all kinds of different places. So it's amazing. And so if you have deep 11 lines, this isn't a good place too because you can't use filler there. So many good applications for PRF gel. It is harder to process, but and it requires a little bit longer processing time, but well worth it depending on the application. Again, that's a quick video on the differences between I like to keep it in line because yes. First generation PRP, second PRF, and then third PRF gel. So it's perfect. So again, like, subscribe, share with friends. And if you have any friends asking or you're having a dinner conversation about, like, I got PRP and somebody else brings up PRF. And again, you know how the rabbit hole happens. Like, you're on the internet, you start searching for PRP and yes. then you hear the difference. So now you know, and share this with friends so they know as well. And again, like, subscribe, all of that.
Let
so
us know you your experiences. We love to hear them. Yeah.
Absolutely. And if you want to hear anything more specific, you let us know. Because again, we're here to revitalize your look, your health, and your sex life. Thank you.
Thank you.